I'm like, hallelujah, praise God, Almighty, the Most High, Alpha and Omega in the sky. I'm like, hallelujah, praise God, Almighty, the Most High, Alpha and Omega in the sky. I'm like,
made in the image of God, with a blunt my mouth and a bitch on the side. Hold up, wait a minute, my life need a massage. Happy yander with a money menage. Me dirt broke, that's a money mirage. Run on my city like I'm the Wizard of Oz. Everybody wanna know what I devise. Everybody wanna know, yeah.
What's up, bro?
What up?
You ready for this podcast?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yep, I can hear you.
Alright, okay. How's work, bro? How's work?
Horrible. Just like every single fucking day.
Oh wow. What did you have to do?
I work at a Marriott, so I do like call reservations for booking hotel rooms. It's great.
Yeah, fair enough. Is there like a restaurant as well in there, or?
No, I wish. If only. I'd be much more fatter than I actually am.
Well, I'm skinny, but I work in a restaurant with food, but there's also a hotel as well.
There's a hotel across the street, but I work at the call reservation center, so.
Ah, fair enough. How long has it taken us to do this podcast? We've been wanting to do this for ages.
I know it has. I know. And it's been like a month now in the making? Because, like, I messaged you, and ironically, just, like, it was just like, yo, you should, like, bring people on the podcast. And then I didn't think you were actually going to take me seriously. And then you were like, let's fucking do it. I was like, oh, crap. Yeah. And then I was like, okay, well, I gotta make time in my schedule, and then my schedule has just been fucking me over lately, dude.
Whoa, oh, shit. And a little sound effect, clapping. Hey. It's about time. But yeah, anyway, have you been, like, watching YouTube, like, the YouTube boxing with KSI and Logan Paul?
Yeah, I have. I've been like keeping up to date on that, and like I'm gonna watch it when it happens. Like, I'm gonna pay to watch that because it's like it's the biggest meme of my generation so far. So I mean,
it really is. Who do you think is gonna win?
To be 100% honest with you, KSI, because KSI has more experience. While Logan's more built, KSI has more experience, and I think experience takes over heavyweight championships any day. So
yeah, plus KSI beat Joe Weller in the last one, so that kind of makes sense.
Exactly.
What do you think of the press conference of Logan walking out?
Oh, I think it's freaking, like, he's trying to, like, prove that he's all tougher and everything, but it just makes him look like more of a pussy.
It does. I was just like, is that it? I wanted to have, like, a proper, like, hugging or some shit.
Exactly.
What about Jake Paul and Deji? That's like a comedy show.
Oh my god, dude. That's like a sitcom in the making.
Who do you think's going to win that one?
I think, honestly, out of that one, Jake Paul. Just because of the matter of the fact that he's just who he is. And I feel like it's... while Deji is KSI's brother and everything, and like everything like that, I just don't think that Deji's the kind of like person to be a fighter. So...
Yeah, to be fair to him, he has been training, so fair play to him for that one.
Exactly.
But yeah, it's just going
to be... What's your opinion on the new song, bro?
Logic's new song?
Yeah.
Oh, bro. I've had that on repeat the whole day.
same here.
I just can't get enough of it, really. I'm excited for Supermarket and the soundtrack that comes with it.
Oh, dude. You don't even understand. Like, when pre-orders for his book come out and, like, for the soundtrack and everything come out, I am going to be one of the first people to pre-order it. I put money on it.
Yeah, I'm going to be there straight away. Do you think they'll put it on, like, exactly, a merch website or what?
I think so. I think he might do something like special for his fans, like his loyal fans. Yeah. Like some like promo code that only other people would have to like decipher and get. I feel like that's something Logic would do. So.
Yeah, I'm hoping for that. Have you been to any of his shows before?
I've been to. Crap, hold on. Okay, so I went Under Pressure Tour. Actually, no, While You Wait Tour, Under Pressure Tour. The Incredible True Story Tour, Everybody, and I was at his college show when he first performed Bobby Tarantino 2, like, live ever. Oh, shit. I was at that show. God. Yeah.
I was meant to go and see him with the Incredible World Tour when he came in the UK, but it got cancelled because, I don't know, I think that might have been around the time with all the anxiety stuff, but I'm not 100% sure.
Yeah, that... when his management team canceled the entirety of the tour. I remember reading that, and I was in science class when that happened, and I felt bad for everybody. I was like, damn,
yeah, people don't get to enjoy the show. I was so disappointed. I was like, no! But then I got to see him in November, so that was all right. That was cool. In Manchester.
Yeah.
Probably the best experience I've ever had. Whoop, shit.
Exactly. I was gonna take my ex to go see the Bobby Tarantino versus Everybody tour, because she was like, "Well, I want to go see him and like all this stuff." And then she broke up with me, and I was like, "Nope, you're not going anymore. Neither am I, because I cannot get off work."
Oh shit!
Yeah, exactly.
So Chance the Rapper's released some songs recently, hasn't he?
Yeah, he has. Bro, I listened to those on repeat up until yesterday when One Day came out, because Chance the Rapper is my shit as well.
Yeah, I haven't had a proper listen to them yet, but there was some rumors going around that there was going to be a possible album soon as well.
Yeah, I've heard those. I don't know how much 100% I'm going to be like I don't know how to word it, like how much I believe it, because I mean, he said he was gonna drop an album last year, and that, like, yeah. I mean, he was touring all of last year, but I mean, still.
The last project was Coloring Book, right?
Yeah, I think that was 2 years ago, wasn't it? I think.
Jesus Christ, that is a long time.
I think I got Google.
What else have we got? Do you listen to a rapper called Tyrese?
Yes, I've heard of him. I haven't listened to him. Well, I've listened to a couple of his songs. I found him through a YouTube video, some like YouTube guys. They did like a prank with him in it, like the rapping at McDonald's or something like that.
Yeah, I love that. I just love to go there one day and just redo a version of that in the UK. That would just be mad.
Yeah. But yeah, Coloring Book came out 2 years ago. Holy shit.
Oh wow. But yeah, Hi-Rez has got an album coming out in August called Humble But Hungry. It's his second album. He says it's his best work yet, and he's got a song coming called We Want Change, which is about like school shootings and stuff. So.
Yeah, because didn't his cousin die in that one in Florida or whatever?
Yeah, that's it. That's the one.
Yeah, I remember that was all over his Instagram for the longest time. And then him and that, and then I like him just because of how, like, humble he is about himself. And the fact that he's like, oh, I'm a rapper, but guess what? I'm going to make fucking chicken wing sauce, too. Like, who does that? Like, who fucking does that?
He's making a comic book as well.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah. And I was currently doing handwritten thank you letters to people who pre-ordered his album.
Oh, wow. Like, yeah, I think more rappers need to be like him.
And then
because I hate these up and coming Little Pumps and everything. Because don't get me wrong, they are in the music industry and everything, and I can't bag on them because they're making more money than I ever will at the age that I am right now. But at the same time, it's like they waste so much of their time and money doing stupid stuff like drugs and everything. I just can't get behind it.
Yeah. Absolutely stupid. I don't know why people even bother with it. It's just, it's not fun. It's not cool. It's not, I don't even know. It's just stupid.
Like, weed is one thing, but, like, popping Zans and doing all that shit, like, that's how you die. Like, I'm sorry. Like, I don't do things unless it's, like, given to me medically. That's just my opinion on everything, though.
Yeah, that's true, actually. Is there any topics you wanted to bring in today?
No, bro, just I'm pumped about this whole new freaking, because I'm waiting for, after last night with that song, I'm like, I need to hear more music now, because it's good. He went back to his old Young Sinatra and everything, and it's just like, oh my god, like nut central.
Did you see his Instagram story about people saying about the Young Sinatra vibe, and then there's other people saying that there isn't, and they want the Young Sinatra vibe back?
Yep.
It's ridiculous.
it's so easy to pull out the fake fans anymore. Like there are so many people at my school that are like, oh, you like Logic too? What's your favorite song? And I go, oh, my favorite song's like a, Superhero off his, like, first mixtape. And they're like, oh, I like 1-800 or Every Day. And I'm just like, I don't like you anymore.
the 1-800 fans.
Yeah.
The typical, that's the only song I know. Look at me. I know who he is now.
Exactly, exactly. But, I mean, there's a limit to those people that I can take. And a lot of them just think that they're, like...
assholes?
I don't know. Yeah, exactly. They're just assholes to everybody in the Rat Pack community, and it pisses me off.
Yeah, I mean, if some of the 1-800 fans are okay, but, like some of them, like, if they're interested in knowing who Logic is more, then I'm like, yeah, I'll respect you, but if that's the only song you listen to, just get out of the sight.
Exactly, exactly.
Like, I've listened to him since 2011.
No, that's 2012 was when I picked up on it for me. What's the name of the mixtape? Oh god. Undeniable came out. Undeniable came out. That was the first one I heard.
Yeah. Well, I didn't really hear a mixtape first. I just heard like individual songs. I think the first one that I remember listening to was the Spotlight. I think that was from Undeniable.
Yep, Spotlight was on Undeniable. I heard of him through buddies of mine, and then, like, I was like, oh, yeah, like, I'll listen to him whenever I can, you know, all this stuff, and then I was watching a FaZe Clan video, their trick-shotting montage, and his song was, and I was like, this dude's actually kind of really freaking good, and, like, I just fell in love with him from there.
Yeah, that's where I found him from FaZe.
I
didn't find him, like any other people, I just saw FaZe. I was like, it took me ages to find a song. Absolutely ages. I just couldn't find it. I was struggling for hours. I was like, what is this song called?
And then exactly. Yeah, I was at a record store to get his album, Under Pressure. I was the first person to buy it. I've still got the original copy of the CD that I bought of, like, the Sam Spratt drawing that he did, that Sam Spratt did in the basement. I've got that album. And then I've got the vinyl of the Under Pressure. And then I've got the vinyl of Incredible True Story and Everybody. And now all I need to do is get vinyl of Bobby Tarantino too, and I'm set to go.
They do vinyl for Bobby Tarantino?
Yeah, for the second one, there's a company who's doing it.
Oh, right.
Who does a lot of vinyls for Def Jam, and they're only doing a certain amount. I don't know when they're gonna release them, but my mom and dad have just been like, "What, did you know this?" And I'm just like, "Yes, mom, I did."
Well, what about that Keanu Reeves song? There's some hype going on about that one.
Dude, that song, like, I think it's gonna be amazing. I think it's gonna be freaking awesome.
It's gonna be one of those bangers.
What was that?
It's gonna be a banger.
It is. It's gonna be a song that I be listening to until, like, probably the day I die. Like, honestly. Yeah. It's just as hyped up as Flexecution was, and I was never let down with that song. When that song came out, that was my shit. I bumped that for so long.
Same. I was just there, like, with my headphones, riding a bike for the whole day. I just had Persecution on repeat. I was like, oh my god, how can I get not get bored of this song?
You did it again.
Jesus, it's 1:05 here in the UK. Oh my god.
You're kidding me. Dude, it's only 7 p.m, bro.
Oh, wow. But yeah, you think that Keanu Reeves song is going to be Ultra 85, or is it going to be in the Supermarket album, or what?
I think, honestly, I think he's just going to keep teasing it until Ultra 85.
Yeah.
Like, I don't see it as being something, because, I mean, it could be. I could be utterly wrong, and it could be on Supermarket, but I don't know. That's just, like, with the song that just came out that's supposed to be on the Supermarket album, or the Supermarket soundtrack, like, I don't know. It just doesn't, like, listening to that and then listening to this, it's just, it doesn't sound anything alike. But, I mean, logic can go from whatever way to whatever way. So, I mean, it really just all depends on how he's feeling at the time.
Yeah, like, to be fair, with that Overnight from Bobby Tarantino 2, when he teased that before everybody came out, apparently that was, like, later on, that was just scrapped from the album, and then later on, we just got it from Bobby Tarantino 2. I was like, what? I recognize this.
Yeah. Exactly. People were like, oh, like, I think it was good that he didn't put it on everybody, because I don't think that song would have fit in anywhere. No. Like,
it's a good song, though. It's a good song.
It is a good song. It's one of those songs that I can listen to all day, every day, and be okay with it, because it's not like every day where it's really repetitive and everything, so.
I'm a fan of every day.
I'm a fan of it, too. But when it comes on the radio constantly, it's just, it gets really repetitive really fast.
The only Logic song on the radio that comes on in the UK is 1-800.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, I was in McDonald's and I heard it, and I was like, oh, hello.
My teacher played it at 1-800 during a test once, and I started freaking out, and everybody thought I was having a seizure. They were like, Logan, you know we're taking a test, right? And I was like, yeah, do you think this is going to stop me?
And then you understand the artist.
So when do you think Supermarket's going to come out?
I don't know. I'm thinking he's going to go for a maybe November. No, nah, not November. What am I about? I'm thinking like September. That would seem like a reasonable time.
Yeah, I'm thinking. I'm thinking around that time too. I'm thinking either that time or like November. Yeah. I don't know if it would be. That'd be a great early Christmas present.
You think the soundtrack will like come out the same day, or are they gonna release the soundtrack then the book, or what?
See, that's a tough one, because I'm thinking it's gonna be released on the same day, but you know, I feel like with the way things are going, and it's like, this is the easiest way to tell when Logic is going to drop an album, because he'll do one song, then right afterwards, like 2 weeks later, he'll drop another song, then 2 days after that, he'll drop another song, and then boom, we've got a surprise album. Like, what?
Yeah.
Like,
but yeah, what about that symbol on the One Day cover?
Oh, I don't know. I think it's Ultra 85 related. He's got a plan on everything. He's such a smart guy. I think he's got everything wrapped in one universe. Yeah. So Bobby Tarantino's going to somehow wrap into Supermarket. And that's going to wrap in, because that wrapped in with everybody. And it wraps in with Ultra 85. And then Tits is all wrapped into Under Pressure. Or Under Pressure's wrapped into Tits and all this stuff. I think it's just all going to be one elaborate story that we just don't see coming.
Yeah, because we still got the Thomas and Kai story, don't we, from Under Pressure, and that still needs to continue from the fourth album.
Exactly. And what a lot of people don't understand is that Under Pressure is your, when you're listening to Under Pressure, it's you're supposed to be Thomas and Kai listening in the spaceship. Like, yeah. that's what that's supposed to be, and not a lot of people understand that. They just think it's some weird album as his first album, and it's like, no. It's all based around a storyline that he's got going, and it's all wrapped in, it all makes itself wrapped around somehow, so.
Yeah, to be fair, when I heard Under Pressure for the very first time, I'm thinking, why is there just some person talking at the end? I was like, what is this?
Exactly. Half the time when I'm driving and those songs come on and then she starts talking, it kills my vibe. Like, honestly. Like, I'll just be jamming out and people start looking at me weird and I'm like, I'm bumping my head and the next thing I know, hello, my name's Polly. I'm just like, shut the f*** up, bitch.
Yeah, it's like when you're just talking and Alexa comes on and you're just like, go away. We don't like
exactly,
you.
Exactly.
Not now.
Exactly.
Oh, God. It is awfully hot in my room. That's horrible. The weather has been absolutely weird. 1 minute it's boiling hot and the next day it's raining. Like, how does that even work?
I wish that was here. It's boiling hot 24/7, so.
Yeah. And then I'm on holiday in 2 weeks to Italy. Oh, that should be fun, melting my tits off.
Italy?
Yep.
Holy mother of Jesus Christ.
I know, right? So that's 1 week I'm going to have to save a podcast for, so I won't be able to do one then, because I'll be melting.
Exactly. And you better hope that no like, new logic stuff comes out while you're gone.
Oh, if that happens. Well, hopefully I'll have Wi-Fi where I'll be staying, so that's one thing.
Hopefully. Fingers crossed.
If I have no Wi-Fi, I'm just going to just get the next plane home.
Exactly. I was just about to make that comment. No Wi-Fi means next plane home.
Yeah. Or just stay at the airport. Airports always have Wi-Fi, I think.
Exactly. Or find the nearest Starbucks.
Do Italy even have Starbucks?
That's a good question.
Whatever thing that looks like a Starbucks or a McDonald's, whatever.
Exactly. Just gotta find an internet cafe.
Yeah. Some sort of bar, restaurant. I'll just stay there and just be like, I'm not moving, I have Wi-Fi now.
Yeah.
As far as I can deal with the Wi-Fi at my house, it's quite absolutely dog shit.
Ugh. Yeah, really?
Well, sometimes it's good, other days it's bad. Like, when I try to play, like, Fortnite, I'm just there, like, lagging all over the place. It's like Doctor Who type shit. I was like, what the fuck's going on? I'm like, who else is using the internet? Get off it now.
Yeah, I feel ya. That's me when I'm trying to play Fortnite. What do you think of Season 5?
Well, I don't really think much of it because I don't buy any of the stuff on it.
Gotcha.
I'm just a default skin noob.
You're just a default skin noob? Oh, man.
Yep.
I've been playing the game way too long, and then when I could finally start affording to buy skins, that's when I was just like, fuck it, all my money's going into it right now. Just.
I can afford to buy the skins, but, like, do I really want to pay money just to do a dance move?
Yeah, I feel you.
When I could just, like, wreck people and get them embarrassed and be like, oh, a default skin kill, but yeah, no. Yep, that's right. Sit down.
Yeah.
Was there anything else you wanted to add?
No, bro, just keep up what you're doing, man. I like your Instagram page, bro, so.
Cheers, bro. Make sure you keep doing yours as well. Then we can, like, work together on stuff in the future, and, you know?
Exactly. I'm definitely down to do so. I just, like, I'll post for a certain amount of time, and then all of a sudden I have to stop, and it's for personal reasons. But, I mean, like, I always come back. It's never something that it's, like, I'm gone forever. I'm always going to come back to it.
Yeah.
But there are points where it's just, like, social media is just not up my alley. Especially just the constant bickering that I see. Like, I had to leave after the whole X and, or not the whole, the whole Jess and Logic thing, because it was just a bunch of people fighting in every comment section. It's just like, nope, I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it. So then I decided to get off of it, and I didn't come back until X passed away. Like, that's when I was just like, fuck it, I need to come back.
Yeah, I was so good when I saw it. I was like, nah, that's not true. That's not true. Then I saw the actual massive power graph. I was like, oh, shit, it is true.
Exactly. I commented on it, too. I was just like, I'm not going to believe a single word until something's true. Like, someone makes a true statement about it. 2 hours later, they made a full statement about it on their Twitters. I was like, well,
Yeah, like, most people were saying, like, oh, yeah, they were shouting at each other, blah, 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 blah. I was like, yeah, right. they're still together, surely.
Exactly.
I started to know, well, I started getting a bit fishy about him when Logic had his Zane Lowe interview, and, like, I was thinking, does he have the ring on? Jess does not appear in this at all. I was like, what's going on?
Yeah, it all started clicking for me when I realized that he put his house up for sale. Like,
oh, yeah.
Oh. Like, and now his new house is freaking huge.
It is. Oh, my God. But he still has no hair yet. He's still bald.
Exactly.
What do you think of his bald look? Do you prefer him with hair or without?
That's a hard question to answer because, like, That's the rap Bruce Willis, bro. If he's not bald, he's not the rap Bruce Willis anymore. So, I mean, I think he looks better bald, honestly. I think he looks a lot younger bald, and I don't know why, but I think really? He does. And I think I think he's just more comfortable being bald. And so, I mean, in the end of the day, it's whatever he wants. And I think he looks good with it, so...
Yeah, he looks good with it both ways, but I'm just used to seeing him with hair.
Yeah, he's used to seeing him with the hairline that goes past China, yeah.
Yep. Like, when I watch, like, the Young Savage videos, I'm like, this is the Logic I know.
Exactly. I can't tell you how many times I watch old... how many times I've watched, old interviews, and I'm just like, man, I miss his hair.
Yeah, true. Like, it, when him and Big Sean were in an interview, they said that he switched haircuts. I was like, ha. I hope they do another collab.
I hope they do, too. Whenever they collab, it's straight fire in the booth for however long they do anything. And it's just like, I think that they're like the dynamic duo, if you will.
Yeah. Well, what did you think of Dizzy Wright and Dizzy Wright's dope talent?
I think Dizzy Wright and Logic are like a good collaborating artist group too. There, just mainly for the fact being that they're two separate people, but in most ways they're alike because they've lived kind of both the same life.
Yeah.
And like, I don't know, they both kind of rap about the same type of shit sometimes. And
yeah. I was hoping for, like, a Young Jedi sort of vibe to it.
Yeah, exactly.
But I think most people felt a bit disappointed with Logic's verse in that one.
Dude, a lot of people were disappointed in his verse with Royce da 5'9".
Oh, I love
like,
that.
That song is so freaking good. Same with that song you did with Tech N9ne. What was that, Sriracha? Everybody was so disappointed with him in that. Like, and, like, I get where...
I like Sriracha.
I do too. I hate Joyner Lucas, but...
Oh, yeah, the little beef.
I mean, like... Yeah, but, like, I feel like he just took it way too far with the way he tweeted things. Like, I think, like, it should be dealt with the way that rappers used to deal with beef over the mic, not over Twitter. Like...
Yeah, that's true.
But I feel like the reason he didn't go over the mic with it is just because he knows that Logic is better than him in every sense.
Yeah, true.
There's going to be so much controversy for me just saying that right there.
Well, I don't have that many viewers for there to be a lot of controversy. I'm not famous.
Not yet.
Oh, I wish. I wish there was. Hopefully one day. You never know.
Speak it into existence, brother.
Yeah. What do you think of my recreation of the Everyday music video?
I have not seen it yet. I need to get on it and see it, but I have not seen it yet, so...
You do. To be fair, I'm actually pretty proud of it. I was like, oh, shit, I actually think I did well with this one.
Is it on... What is it on again? Is it on Vimeo?
It's on YouTube.
It is on YouTube?
Yeah, I'll send a link after this podcast.
Okay.
I haven't got anything else to add. Have you got anything else to add?
Nope, that should... I think that's it, man.
Well, what do you think I should outro this podcast to?
Like, what do you mean by that?
Well, what song? What song should I put for the outro?
One Day, obviously.
Alrighty. I have to edit it in as well. Have you got a YouTube channel?
I had a YouTube channel. I stopped uploading to it, but I mean, it's On Edge Gaming, and it's cringy. Like, I'm the most cringiest person you will ever meet in your entire life, because like I started this channel like I think 5 years ago, maybe six. I don't know. However long ago, I used to upload all the time, and then school, like it was all about school. Like I had to dedicate 100% of my time to school. I couldn't dedicate 100% of my time to YouTube. I had to make the choice, and I did, and I just never could get back into it. So
is it worth putting in the description for a subscribe?
if you want to, go ahead, be my guest. I'll send you a link.
Yeah, I'll put your channel in the description. Oh, and I'll also link me your Logic fan page on Instagram as well, so I'll put that in the description as well. So make sure everybody follows him. If you don't, then I'll just come to your house and just shit on your face while you sleep.
I'll murder you in your sleep.
And that as well, afterwards.
No cap. No. Dude, I wonder how confused that one guy was when you were tagging the Logic_updates, because it, like... I saw that and I was just like, I hope he knows that's not me. Like,
oh yeah, I'll figure. Hang on a minute, is that him? I wasn't. And then I saw his Logic 3 at one up there. So I was like, oh shit. Oh well.
Yeah, exactly. I wasn't able to change my name to Logic Updates when he changed his name to Logic. So, because it was already taken, which was sad. But
Logic Updates, if you're watching this, fuck you, bro. Psych. Just kidding.
Just kidding.
Taking the usernames. Ah, there it is. Got it.
Okay. Right.
Thank you for joining this podcast, bro. Really appreciate it. Keep doing what you're doing. And good luck for whatever you're going to do next. Hopefully I'll have you have you on the next podcast or whenever you're free.
Exactly, yeah. Not a problem, man. Just hit me up whenever.
Alrighty. Thank you very much, bro.
Not a problem. You've agreed with your day, man.
Cheers, bro.
Cheers, bro.
And that is it for the podcast. Logic 301 updates. Thank you so much for coming on. It's been a pleasure doing this podcast with you. Hope you all enjoyed this podcast. We're going to do the outro to One Day.
And maybe one day I'll be wise. 'Cause maybe one day I'll be further from here. Put all of my faith into tomorrow. Dark days coming up all night. All the thing I know is gonna be alright. You ever wonder what it means to make it by any means and finally attain your dreams? On a come up where they run up from the world of many fiends. I've been at it since the teen. Get this money, get the cream. Hard work and sacrifice, but now that I know what I mean. Most of these rappers ain't got no class like bomb threats. It being ill is a disease, it's the onset. And it don't matter where you at, if you white or if you black, if you rich or you poor, we gon' always want more. As long as I got the floor, I'ma use this power to paint a picture of unity. And yeah, I'm ripping it up with an energy like it's two of me. Fuck the lights and the cameras right now, it's just you and me. And one day, I'll be richer than I was before. One day, I'ma have enough money to buy the store. One day, like Sinatra said, you know I'm finna do it my way. You on the road to success, I took the highway.